My name is Carlos Santoro. I am a research faculty at University of New Mexico, the Department of Chemical and Biological Engineering. Today I'm going to talk about the technology we are working on. It's a bioelectrochemical system, particularly it's a microbial fuel cell. This device is based on carbonaceous material, and the idea is to degrade organic compounds, wastewater, civil and industrial wastewater, to make electricity out of it. Particularly, we are working on the supercapacitive aspect of the electrodes. This is a microbial fuel cell. There is an anode and a cathode. On the anode, electroactive bacteria degrades organic compounds, generating electron flow that is harvested. And on the cathode, there is the reduction of water, the reduction of oxygen, sorry, to water. So it's interesting, this technology, because we can make degrade organic compounds and simultaneously making electricity. One of the biggest problems of this technology is the fact that the bacterial kinetic is very low. The concentration of organic is very low, so bacteria takes time to degrade organic. And another important problem is the cost, very high cost of the material. For that reason, we use a material that are carbonaceous based. This is a carbon brush on a titanium coat. It's a very high surface area. And here we use a pressed pellet of activated carbon with the non-platinum based catalyst. Mainly we use iron. Both of those have like high surface area, so they can have a supercapacitive feature that we use. Another bigger problem of this technology is the fact that the current output is very bad and cannot be utilized directly for harvesting to like power sensor or like to for practical application. So using a supercapacitive way, both electrode, the anode is actually the negative electrode and the cathode is positive electrode of the supercapacitor, we are able to generate the current and power pulses that are actually one order of magnitude higher compared to the continuous operating mode of this system. And we are actually able to predict the output, so we can power a sensor or have a practical application pulse in a shorter amount of time compared to the traditional way of combining those electrodes with the external supercapacitor. So now we're going to talk about supercapacitive microbial desalination cell. So microbial desalination cell is composed by three different compartments. The anode compartments in which there is a carbon brush, there is a sludge, activated sludge. Activated sludge contains organics. In the middle chamber, there is a desalination chamber that contains salty water. And here on the right, there is the cathodic chamber that contains other water or wastewater. So the three chambers are separated by two ion exchange membranes that works as a physical separator and help the exchange of ions that we want to move. Particularly the anode, it's in anaerobic condition, so it's negatively charged. The cathode is in aerobic condition because there is oxygen, so it's positively charged. This allows the ions in the middle of the chamber that are mainly sodium, that is a positive ion, and chlorine, that is a negative ion, to migrate. The chlorine, that is negatively charged, move to the positively charged electrode, and the sodium, that is positively charged, is electrostatically attracted to the anode. This generates on the two electrodes an electrochemical double layer that allow the charge, the self-charge and the rapid discharge of the electrodes, generating high current and power pulses that can be used for powering sensor or powering small devices. So also in this case, we use a cheap carbonaceous material and non-platinum based material like iron and so on. And this is, we actually switched the order of the membrane to allow electrostatic attraction of ions inside the desalination chamber to actually increase further the desalination rate compared to the existing technology.